How does one define obsession? The night spent staring at the ceiling with the noise of your thoughts and ideas. It has been a roller coaster ride for us the past few months, building some crazy stuff and going places with them. Who'd have thought that these two idiots who had never built anything before in their lives would come this far? We started off our journey as complete noobs with an old Continental GT that we turned into an even more stunning Bomber GT. Then we built a couple of out-of-this-world looking scramblers, resurrected a couple of legends that were left for dead. And here's yet another story where we managed to do something extremely childish just because we can. Today is a very big day for us because ever since we started Holy Shift, people have been going on and on and on about us maybe doing a car build. So Harsha has gone and found a car for us to build, and I haven't seen it yet and I don't even know what it is. So let's go check it out together. My first car build, so excited. So I reach a garage and walk up to a dust-covered something. All I know is it looked nothing like a car. And Harsha and I took the wraps off the thing and what do we find? A first-gen Omni of all things. At least what was left of it. What was he thinking?
So I thought we should get something really insane for our first car build. The ultimate kidnap vehicle is now going to be turned into the ultimate... vision.
Okay, here's the story. I made a render of a lifted Omni that looked like the ultimate adventure road trip bug out vehicle ripping through the desert a few years ago out of sheer boredom at my old job. Never in my wildest dreams did I even think that someone would actually be mad enough to build one. And if we actually go ahead and build this thing, we would be building the world's first lifted Omni. I don't even know how we would go about doing this.
This is the biggest thing that we've ever done. Nobody's ever tried to lift a Maruti Suzuki Omni before. So we're going to need a lot of help to make this thing a reality. So Rohit is calling up the guys at M86 and Harsha has already called a tow truck to take it there.
The Maruti Suzuki Omni, or simply the Maruti van, was actually the Japanese Suzuki Carry that was launched in India in the 1980s. These came with a tiny 3-cylinder 800cc mill that put out around 36 horsepower. Royal Enfields make more than that these days. Though the Suzuki Carry went through major iterations in the international market, the Indian version saw only a couple of facelifts and was finally discontinued this year after over a 30-year production run. So I'm hoping this will be a fitting tribute to the car. After a few days of prolonged chai and sutta sessions with the guys at M86, I think we have a plan in place to build the ultimate road trip Omni, which is also going to double up as our shop truck and also be the occasional kidnap vehicle. Anyway, here's how we plan on doing it. The Omni we got doesn't run or even move for that matter, so we first get rid of the stock engine and drivetrain, swap it with a 4-cylinder 1000cc engine and differential from the Maruti Suzuki Gypsy. Then we add spacers on top of the front shocks and on the rear leaf springs to raise the van to the desired height. We also got to add spacers to the wheel hubs to increase the track width of the car to compensate for the increase in height and extend the lower arms and all the other running gear up front. Then slap off brand new 235 section tires. After that, we seal off the windows in the back and build a beefy external roll cage and a roof rack. And then build a second rack to carry a second bike at the rear of the van. Then we bolt on a huge bull bar and a bash plate with 6 auxiliary lights up front and a huge light bar in the back. And finally, to top it all off, we give the vehicle a badass paint job, which we're still yet to decide.
Now here's a catch. We have a PD Army meetup coming up at the garage in a month, and Rohit plans to reveal the finished vehicle there and also screen the season finale. Will we be able to finish it? I don't think so, but let's give it a try.
We're just a month away from the reveal and we start off the build as usual by disassembling the vehicle.
There wasn't much on the Omni that Harsha got us. The windshield was shattered, the front doors wouldn't open, and there's rust everywhere. We pulled out all the seats and other interior stuff.
Surprisingly, the engine on our Omni wouldn't run. So we dropped off the engine, transmission and all the other running gear and put it aside to maybe bring it back to life for our future builds. The team is on a hunt for a new engine for our Omni. In the meanwhile, let's go tackle the rust. Rust is usually caused by water stagnated in the nooks and crannies of a vehicle, which slowly but surely starts oxidizing the metal and starts spreading. The only solution to this is to replace the affected area with fresh metal.
The front wheel arches are also pretty badly rusted, but we're gonna have to cut that area off while making the wheel arches bigger anyway. So that's one area we don't have to do rust repair on.
The Omni stock differential was in no condition to handle the massive tires we're gonna put onto it. So here's what we did.
So we're gonna replace the stock diff with a much tougher differential from the Gypsy, but it is not so straightforward. The Gypsy's diff is offset to the left, which is great for that vehicle because it is a 4x4 and it helps with the position of the transfer case. Our car, on the other hand, is only gonna be a rear wheel drive, which means no transfer case, which in turn means that the differential and the transmission are gonna be misaligned. So with a lot of precision hacking and welding, we move the diff to the middle of the axle where we need it. This is gonna help us kick the wheels of the car almost outside the body, which will increase the track width and make the car a little less likely to roll over. The track width of the car is the distance between the center lines of the two wheels on the same axle. To give our Omni the go-anywhere capability and look, we're going to be putting some massive Maxxis Trepidor off-road tires on this car.
Now that we have the wheels and tires ready, we jacked up the vehicle to the exact stance we need and just stared at the awesomeness that was going to unfold for a while.
After we mocked up the wheels and set the stance for our car, we then move on to making the spacers for the suspension to match our ride height. Then extend the lower arms and the other running gear to get the right camber angle.
We built some huge spacers to kick the tires out so that it matches with the track width at the back.
Eagle-eyed among you must have noticed that the wheels and the rear hub are from a Gypsy, whereas the front hubs are stock from the Omni. And here's the problem, the Gypsy hub has a PCD of 5x139.5, whereas the Omni has a PCD of 4x114.3. PCD refers to primary ciliary dyskinesia. That's not right. PCD refers to pitch circle diameter, and what this means in the case of the Gypsy is that there are 5 bolts on the hub and the diameter of the imaginary circle drawn through the center of all the bolts is 139.5 mm, but whereas the Omni has only 4 bolts on the hub and the diameter of the same imaginary circle is only 114.3 mm. Now you know what the problem is, but this is where our spacers come in. So our spacers are going to convert the bolt pattern on the Omni to match that on the Gypsy. Simple.
The Omni's wheels are going to stick completely outside the body, so the stock wheel wells don't serve much purpose. All the more reason to cut them off, get rid of all the rust in that area, and also to create a lot more cabin space.
We use the rear wheel arch shape as a template and hack up the front doors and make new wheel wells that will allow the wheels to move freely from lock to lock.
The Omni's wheels are so big that the stock wheel arches are no way close to accommodating them. So what we're going to do is, we're going to seal this whole part and create new wheel arches over here, and the doors are going to start from here. Minto is going to need a ladder for sure.
Then we made four really cool looking mud guards for the wheel arches. So the stock Omni comes with a very tiny 3-cylinder 800cc engine that obviously lacks the extra muscle that is required to carry around all that extra weight that we're going to be giving the vehicle.
We found a 1-liter engine and transmission from a total gypsy. That's just perfect for our build.
We took the engine apart and rebuilt the whole thing again, as if we didn't have enough time lapses on the video already. And to give it more power, we ported the cylinder head.
And you must be thinking, what the f*** is porting, bro? Porting is the process of modifying the intake and exhaust ports to improve the quality and quantity of the airflow to add a few extra horses to the stable. And this simple process helps give the engine that extra punch it needs to carry around all that excess weight that we were talking about earlier.
As this car's kidnapping days are way in the past, we don't really need the sliding doors. Plus, these things are going to come in the way of our external roll cage. We sealed the driver's side of the car and converted the other side into a gull wing. Now who says gull wings are only for expensive cars? Ta-da! Now this car, with its highest center of gravity, is going to be super roll happy. But instead of preventing the car from rolling over, we just prevent death from happening to us by building an external roll cage around the car.
So we got a truckload of 1.5 inch metal tubing and went full potato on the vehicle.
Rohit has been dying to paint this thing ever since we started this build. Let's see what has got in store for us.
We are 7 days away from revealing the vehicle, out of which 2 days are just going to be spent shooting the finished product, which basically means we only have 5 days left. So while we were out figuring out the paint scheme, our vehicle was cleaned, stripped of the original paint, given a nice huge serving of filler, then it was given a hand job by multiple men, followed by a happy coat of primer. After which, we paint the base color with a very tactical looking grey. We wanted to wrap the whole vehicle originally because of the tight deadline we were working with, which turned out to be an epic fail because of all of the tricky contours on the van. So we then switched to plan B, which is giving the vehicle a two-tone paint scheme, and this is going to delay the whole process by 2 days that we don't have. But here's the upside. I hate the idea of wrapping vehicles. There's something very unfulfilling about it. So it is f***ing awesome that we get to paint the vehicle and not wrap it. But this means the time for troubleshooting is going to be reduced by a whole day.
We are 3 days away from the reveal and nothing horrible has happened yet. So if everything goes as planned, I think we should be able to pull this off.
So we need a name for our Frankenstein's monster of a car made from Gypsy and Omni parts. And this is what we came up with. Suzuki is nowhere close to bringing their actual Jimny here to India anyway, so isi se kaam chala lo.
And also the Jimny, because this Omni looks like it just hit the gym. Yeah. Here.
We got a pair of these 20-liter jerry cans so that we can carry more fuel or beer if necessary.
So we got this giant light bar in the back up here for those annoying people who keep honking and flashing their lights for no reason.
We've got set of 6 fog lamps up front to turn night into day, and also source these sexy looking LED headlights. We already have space for one motorcycle inside the vehicle, but we figured out 2 is always better than 1, so we got a rack in the back to accommodate the second motorcycle for extra adventure.
Now all that's left to do is to put this Frankenstein's monster through its paces in a road trip someday soon. What happens when you refuse to grow up, got lunatics as friends, and a penchant for petrol-fueled madness? This, Meet the Jimny, our newest creation. Made from the ashes of a rust bucket of an Omni and powered by a gypsy. No, we're not going zombie hunting, we're just being a little extra. So all of you who are waiting for us to build a car, what do you think?
This is something else, man. Plus the name's really cool. Jimny, like a Jimny.
Bahut acha tha, experience bhi acha hua.
God, something which is different. Making an Omni is such kind of thing is.
Doors, the butterfly doors. I'm like, they don't even have that in the RX 8.
It totally looks insane. And if Maruti produced an Omni like that, I think a lot more people would have Omnis in their garages.
And if anyone can do it, it's only Holy Shift.
The Jimny marks the end of season 1 for Holy Shift. Will we see these goofballs with season 2 of Holy Shift on PowerDrift again? Yes, hopefully soon enough. But here's something that's barreling towards you soon and fast. Very, very fast.